Hi, this is Sean. In this video, I'm going to go over the Maya liquid surfaces pond, and I'm going to go over the basic attributes of size and depth, mesh density, water speed, and mesh conversion. Then I will go all over wakes, custom collisions, and then we'll make a boat that also kicks out some foam that trails behind it. In addition to that, I highly recommend referencing the Maya help docs on the fluid nodes, and you can find the most probably the most important documents that you'll be looking for are under simulation and effects, fluid effects reference, and fluid effects nodes. The two that I like would reference would be the fluid shape node document and then also the fluid emitter document, and you can see both are rather long. So here we are in Maya. I've created a pond already, and you find the fluid ponds that you can create under the Dynamics tab. So hitting F5, going to Fluid Effects and Pond. We've already created the pond, but let's tear this off and let's create a wake so that we can start to see that this is a dynamic surface. If you were to change the size of your pond, I recommend dialing in numbers. So 25, 25, you can make it bigger. This number is the height of the fluid surface. You can modify these wakes, the wake strength, by modifying the rate and the density voxels per second. So those two parameters. And so you can see right now the fluid pond is not, it doesn't have a height volume that's able to deal with this. It's capping off at the top. So, but in general, you want to keep this number as optimized as possible, meaning that you want it just shy of or just slightly higher than the highest wake that you're going to be creating. These, by default, the pond calculates as a constrained surface, meaning that it probably uses the sort of famous equation of the Navier-Stokes is an optimized fluid calculation, and you have the ability to turn that off. Well, you're turning off the boundary, the perceived boundary. It's still calculating as a Navier-Stokes equation, but if you switch these boundaries to none, you and rewind, you will now not get any default boundary. And you can change the speed of the simulation under the Dynamic Simulation tab. So you can go in here and you can change the viscosity, which will make it the fluid seem thicker. Or you can change the friction or the damp to slow things down, and it'll dramatically, change the look and feel of your simulation. I think you can also change the number of steps that's calculated per frame. You can change the solver to a Navier-Stokes solver if necessary. But a lot of the default parameters are good. Okay, so let's go and create a custom collision. I've built a seashore that we can collide with. So by default here, it is not colliding with the seashore, it's cutting through it. And so the way you would make this, you would select the seashore, select the pod, and you just say, go to Fluid Effects, Make Collide. And so now if we rewind, now you can see that it's colliding with the shore. Okay, great. Let's go to the next step. The next step is we're going to show off our boat. So we've got a little boat here, and you want to set up anything that you're going to declare as a boat or a motorboat at the origin. And so we'll select this boat and we will make it a motorboat. And so you'll see a locator parented to the object or the object parented to a locator. And now if we start the simulation, you'll see, oh, it's actually floating too much. So the attributes that you want to dial in are under the locator shape extra attributes. And so I'm going to dial down the buoyancy. Probably even a little bit more than that. And you can drive this boat. I mean, it has a throttle, so you can like make it go and go backward. And you can also adjust the roll and pitch. If you dial it lower, so I'm just dialing the pitch lower, you can see that as I accelerate or decelerate, the boat will really pitch up. And same thing goes with the roll. The boat, so if we, let's make that throttle low and take that roll down here. And so also let's turn the rudder. All right, so you can see that the boat moves, it follows all these parameters. You can modify the scene scales to make the boat react more or less to the different wakes that are in the scene. But for now, I'm going to create a new wake and parent it to the boat. And we'll size that to an appropriate size. I'm going to parent it to the boat. So I selected the boat, shift selected the object, and then hit P. And now we should see that there's some wake going behind the boat. It's too much. So we've got that emitter selected, and we can go down and modify the density per second, the voxels. So that's better. And now we want to also, let's make this boat, maybe make the boat go a little faster, but also kick out some foam behind it. So we'll turn up the throttle just a tiny bit. But the way that you make foam come out of the boat is that you need to turn on, so on the fluid surface itself, you need to turn on the temperature to dynamic grid. And then on the wake emitter, you need to start kicking out some heat also. So here's the heat voxels per second. And if we turn it up to 1, depending on the size of your simulation, you'll see something. We're working at a pretty small scale. And so we're not seeing a whole lot. So you can really overdrive these numbers sometimes to get better effects if necessary, or work at a different scale. So let's go under the boat and the pond wake emitter, and let's just really overdrive that heat voxels per second. We'll say 5. Okay, so now we can actually see that we're getting a little bit more. And you know, I would, in order to get this all looking correct, you know, you could maybe, you know, change the base resolution of the pond, and you could also, you definitely really need to like sort of get this wake emitter set to a correct parameter, but it's actually starting to look pretty decent now. And then I highly recommend really looking through all of the help docs. Also, it's worth playing with creating a starting point sometimes. I created an alien spaceship. It's a UFO. And this is a wake emitter that I scaled way up. And if we bring this down in contact with the fluid surface, you get what looks sort of like a, you know, sort of an interesting starting point for some water. I mean, or it could just be a repulsor field that this UFO is emitting. And so if you liked that as a starting point, one thing you could do is set the initial state. However, the initial state on these, it's not under the solvers. There is a set initial state under the fluid effects itself. So set initial state right here. I'm gonna hit G. So now you can see that the fluid itself is starting when we rewind at the initial state. All right, well, that's going to wrap up this video. Thanks so much for watching. Have a good night.